Hi everyone. Welcome back to the Prophecies of Victor the Budgie, where you can not only hear budgies channeling the angels, but the angels communicating in reverse songs as well. This is the 70th presentation that Victor talked about in presentation 2. These are the official lessons that the angels sent as training for the new visionaries. At the end of this lesson, we will be doing another remarkable song reversal that Ryan transcribed. Before the reversal, we would like to answer some of the questions that you have in an interview type format.
Now that these 70 lessons are finished, what is the next phase of this religion?
This phase was something that the angels wanted to do, to familiarize people that come here, of what to expect. The next phase will begin once people start to come, and want to participate in this miraculous event. At that point we will be able to take what we have learned and put it into practice. Soon we will be able to witness other prophecies come into fruition, and experience miracles from God and His angels on a regular basis.
How do you explain that some people can hear different messages in the recordings of the budgies, as well as the reversals of the songs?
Many people think that reverse masking is something that is put in songs purposely, by the artist, to create hype about the song. For the most part, that is not the case. It really doesn't depend at all on the artist, their frame of mind, or their subconscious thoughts. The captions totally come from the person who is translating it, and what pathway they take. It also depends on the experience and gifts they have. Like in life, there are many different paths that we can take, some of which are good and bad. In reverse music, if you are connected to the right pathway like Ryan, that pathway will be one that comes from God, and not an evil or confused source.
Throughout the presentations, you often talk about spirituality and spiritual evolution. Can you explain in more detail what they are?
Spirituality is knowing God, the angels and heaven, exists, and experiencing it on a daily basis, as you walk with them. God gives us the choice to believe in what we choose to believe in, and He doesn't punish us if we don't know the truth, or we have learned to believe in something different because of our culture. Spirituality is also knowing that the soul is eternal, and what we do in each lifetime helps us to spiritually evolve, so we can join God in heaven. God and the angels want to know that each soul that joins them in heaven is a good soul, and its being consists of love and compassion for all living things.
What is your vision of evil, and how do we avoid it? Do we have to be sinless and perfect in every way to get to heaven?
No, we don't have to be perfect in every way. God knows and understands the trials and tribulations of humanity. He knows how difficult it is and automatically forgives us when we make mistakes. As long as we have goodness in our hearts and strive to be a better person, we can make it to heaven. The angels classify evil as anything that prevents us from spiritual evolution. When we refuse to correct our evil, God and the angels will try to get us out of our confusion, so we can evolve, like we are meant to do.
Why doesn't God just destroy all the evil that causes pain and suffering in the world?
God gives humanity a choice when it comes to controlling its own place of residence, which is Earth. Certainly, the laws are different in heaven. For the most part, God encourages us to band together to create goodness and miracles that help reverse the evil. It is humanity's choice to make their own laws that govern the world, and the people normally choose good philosophies that will do that. So, in essence, God and the angels' purpose and mission are to help guide humanity in making the right choices, so they can evolve individually and as a civilization as a whole. Another thing they will do is try to prevent future pain and suffering for humanity, especially for those that have no control over it and have to follow along with the majority that do.
What if I do not want to go to heaven?
Again, that is your choice, and that is where reincarnation comes in. If we are not spiritually evolved enough to strive for heaven, we get to live again and hopefully evolve enough in the next lifetime. During our lifetimes, we have to reach a point of understanding and believing in the philosophies of God and the angels in heaven. God will not kidnap our souls and take them to heaven without our consent. We have to want to go there and strive to evolve enough spiritually so we can eventually make it. Once we are there, we have eternity to experience the wonders of the cosmos with God and the angels, and the love and compassion for others is the fuel that sustains us in eternity.
What is heaven like, and will we be in a spiritual or physical form?
Heaven is very similar to Earth, except without the evil and many times better. We will have physical bodies which are much like what we have now, and the divine and heavenly emotions we have with them will be intensified many times over, much like they are in dreams. We will be able to walk with God and the angels and transfer space and time just like they do. We will be able to visit past lives of ourselves and other people we love, and actually intervene if we think we can help them. That is why we all have angels trying to help us, for they are usually past relatives, friends or people that we have loved in present or previous lives. Their goal is to reunite with you in heaven, so you can enjoy the wonders of the universe with them, anytime you wish.
We often hear the angels refer to Ryan as a prophet. Does that put him on the same level as Jesus or Muhammad?
Ryan has said in the past that he is uncomfortable when the angels refer to him as a prophet, for he is a humble man, and does not feel he is equal to other prophets. He prefers to be known as someone who has prophetic writings, or a person who channels the angels, or even a Christian mystic. Ryan feels it is totally up to God and the angels where they want to place him on the spiritual evolutionary ladder. He knows he has a long way to go before he has evolved enough spiritually to reach the level of others in the past who have participated in creating new religions. He also believes that he is not much different than any other man, for we all have gifts that God has given us. It is how we put them to use that makes the difference.
Why do you think it is important for humanity to have a new religion such as this?
That is a good question, and one that has many answers, most of which come from the reasoning of God. Many of the main religions these days still consist of a lot of religious evil, which often results in evil done in the name of God. For most, this is a well-known fact, past or present. Even if a religion is originally inspired by God, it is tailored to the politics of the time, without any real proof of the true philosophies of God and the angels. A majority of people these days, even the ones that say they believe in God, will often refuse to believe the proof that God exists. Why is this? Is it because they really don't believe in God in the first place? Yes, many have their own belief systems that they have been taught, and most will not think outside the box, or accept others have the right to their own belief systems. When our beliefs originate from the culture we have grown up in or learned from, God does not punish us for them, for he knows we may not have a choice. In this new age of spirituality, God and the angels see that most religions are not guiding humanity in the right direction. They recognize our need to be set on a different path, before we end up having no compassion for the future of our children and the earth as a whole. It's also becoming more obvious that even religious people are losing their faith because of the current situation that the world is in. Some who want to believe have no proof that God exists, and only see the evil and untruths that they experience every day. Now, the technology we have allows us to witness something different and miraculous like this via the internet. This is important because it is becoming increasingly hard to go to church without having the risk of getting infected by the COVID-19. So with this religion, we can have a personal relationship with God and the angels without going to church, and through it we can experience the fellowship, for the most part, online.
Do you believe that this religion is the only way that people can get to heaven?
No, on the contrary. That would be religious evil, one of the worst kinds. As I said before, God does not punish us for our beliefs. So if we believe in a religion, and we do not propagate evil because of it, we will still be accepted in heaven, no matter what religion it is. The prerequisite, however, is that we have goodness in our hearts, and don't use the religion we believe in to cause harm on, and judge others. Even God and the angels change their philosophies according to the times and try to work with humanity. They do it in ways we can evolve spiritually during our lifetimes on earth. If we want to keep the religion we belong to, we must seek the good in it and strive to find ways to gain spiritual evolution through it. The first and most important thing being that we believe in and trust in God, the angels in heaven. As long as we do that and maintain love in our hearts and compassion for others, we will find the path to heaven. Keep in mind that if your religion goes against the philosophies of God and heaven, you may not even know where your soul needs spiritual evolution. Thus, if you are not in sync with God and heaven when you pass, you may have to return and try over again.
How do you explain why some people are born into pain and suffering and have no way of having any spiritual evolution during their lifetime?
This is a good question and one that produces much sadness in the hearts of God and the angels. Heaven does not wish to see whole civilizations suffering. Unfortunately, when we die, our soul is attracted to similar situations and people it loved prior to death. It is kind of like karma. So if we were used to having evil in our lives, propagating it, and not producing much good, our souls would be reborn under similar circumstances. It is not a punishment, but a choice the soul makes at the time of rebirth. Given that, God still removes the evil at rebirth, so it will be innocent once again. What we need to do then, in order to prevent that from happening in the next lifetime, is try and find ways to have some kind of spiritual evolution. Even if it is only small steps that you never achieved during your previous life, and that is usually where love and compassion come in. When we can achieve good things, while under extremely difficult circumstances in life, we will move up the spiritual ladder of evolution much quicker. in the next life we will return to a more loving place and have less suffering. We may even take a quantum leap to heaven, for God loves those who create good when they are surrounded by evil. It is basically the same when we go to heaven, for our soul will move up to the highest level of spiritual evolution and will want to be with those we love, for we will be drawn to it.
Why do you think God chose birds to initially bring this religion to the world?
If every miracle could be explained, then it would not be a miracle. Yet there is divine reasoning behind it. When Victor came to Ryan, he was the first bird in the world that started communicating in full-blown speech and understanding what he was saying. It was an incredible breakthrough in animal intelligence that far exceeded anything in the field. It even became more amazing when he started talking about God and spirituality. And he began making prophecies. After that, Ryan worked with over 30 birds that also began to communicate in a similar fashion. As it all unfolded, two more birds came to Ryan that were equally gifted and communicating similar things. The reason God chose birds is because they intensify the miracle. Do you think people would believe Ryan if he said God was saying these things to him without any proof? When birds give their own testimonies, it is a totally different ballgame.
Why do you think God chose reverse to open the channel to heaven?
Victor once said that if he just spoke one way, people would have no interest in it. That is what began to happen, for many thought Ryan was somehow teaching Victor to say these things. Once the reverse came into it, it became impossible for them to make that claim anymore. The reverse intensifies the miracle even more, as it would be impossible for this to happen unless there is some kind of supernatural connection to the soul through God. God didn't stop there though, he took it to the next level and began communicating through these songs that Ryan now transcribes. The songs that Ryan translates in reverse are exactly as they are downloaded from the internet, and there is no doubt that the angels are communicating through them. So, what leads into this next song that Ryan just transcribed? The song Ryan chose today is Stuck With You. Stuck With You is a song by American singer Ariana Grande and Canadian singer Justin Bieber. It was released as a charity single on May 8, 2020.
Yeah. was nothing about that one. Why did my love understand? If you had more separating, what if it were a cash note? I will get to know one now.
That completes this presentation. To hear more, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit our website at theangelscrolls.com.